exhortation is exam time is here.
Anopai afutua ne be menemo ebeche no edi amede atoso ne se enso hwe mere enie.
Exam time is here.
Enso hwe mere enie.
As we appoint leaders after God's own heart to lead this congregation.
Emra yepesi yeyi ni animfo a Onyankopon akoma da omso omo edi asafo yanim.
The process by which biblically qualified leaders are appointed in the church can be likened to students who go through examination.
Ojo kwan ya Bible mu ye fa so eyi ni animfo ema asafo no a etse school for equatron so hwe.
If the students study well and pass the exam successfully in their large numbers without any incidents of malpractice,
the school for no sua dia yie na mo mododo otumi e tron so hwe no mutwa a obi a ankowia e won so hwe ni mu a,
then everyone is happy. Parents, the public, everyone is happy, and everyone recognizes the school as being very good school to go.
Yes, sir. Na mo bia ni age awofo ni a teacher fo obi a so di nani esise o school di school pa esise o do ba ko.
But if on the other hand the students fail woefully to pass the exams,
na emo mu ankoba ni sa na se school fo na obududu ona so hwe no omo a emo mu homwade antini antwa.
Or if their school is one where the incidence of more practices often occur, then the reputation of the school becomes tarnished.
And I say, ekoba ni say school no obeti e say ho de school for no ko wi ansohwe ni mu e ko wi ansohwe ni mu na ma school ni din asay.
And not many people will want to send their awards to that school.
Afi obi a mpese wode ne bakra ekosa school no.
Similarly, the character and demeanor of the individuals who are considered for the appointment of elders and deacons say volumes. It says a lot about their level of Christian maturity. If a brother who is being considered for an appointment as elder or deacon is indeed qualified, is indeed mature and fit for leadership in the church, it will come to light through his conduct during and even after the screening process.
On the other
hand, if a brother who is being considered for appointment as elder or deacon is not qualified, is not matured enough, that also comes to light during and after the screening process.
At the end
of the whole process,
now,
if there is peace and harmony, if there is unity in the church, then everyone recognizes that indeed these brethren are truly matured in Christ.
But
if the process of selecting and appointing elders and deacons, in the process we allow bitterness and bickering and backbiting to gain a better part of us,
na se ankoba ni sa na mumu mra ye impanifo no na ye man ho kwan ma wetime wakame we yetia me ebamu a,
then such act of hostility show that we lack spiritual maturity.
Eno ebe kire se asafo no enyi wo honhum,
it shows that the individuals who try to cause dispute are themselves not spiritually matured.
Na nipa no so a omo na omo de sakasaka yo ne menti ase beba na no so kire se
whether they are candidates or whether they are members of the church,
So that
is why we are saying that selection of biblically qualified elders and deacons is a time of examination.
Enunti na no pay me ka say bredru ye yi empenifo na yanimfo amasafo na e nso hwemre.
It's a time of examination for those who have the desire and for the congregation as a whole.
E nso hwemre e ma won a e pese e bedi mpani e nso hwemre e de ma asafo no nyina.
I want us to turn our attention to Acts chapter 1.
E pese ye hwe bibi asomafo nguma eti baako.
The context begin from verse 12 to 26.
Oshe nyimu edumienu ekwesi aduonu nsia na.
And here in this passage we have a narrative on how the church in Jerusalem filled the leadership void which was created as a result of Judas' departure.
Okay, kan ha uno kwan ya asafo na o Jerusalem no efa so eyi obi esi Judas anam.
Before the Jerusalem church appointed someone into their leadership.
Asana, Jerusalem asafo no ebe yi obi abe company for ne ho no.
The first thing we observe is that the leaders of that church, in this case the apostles, the leaders saw a need, they saw a void, they saw a vacuum in the leadership which needed to be filled.
Ade edi kan kra ye hunu ni se asafo mpanifo na e ho ne hunu se tokro bi abeda empaninie nim a ese se enye obi no wo hye anan.
When you look at verse 21 from Peter's statement, he says there is the necessity that the vacuum created in leadership should be filled.
Wo hye enyimu aduonu ba ko asem a Petro kan ne kire. Petro kan se enwa ko hia se enye obi no wo hye anan.
So appointing elders and deacons and even ministers of the gospel in the church is not something that you do just anyhow. There must be a real need.
Enti se yebe yi asafo mpanimfo asepakanfo a ense se ye ni biara biara ese se ejina bibi so hia bi ehia enti.
And of course, as you can observe from the text, all the 11 apostles were available.
Na wo hwe Bible ni mu a na asomafo du ba ko no omo ho.
Yet Peter and the rest of the apostles recognized that having a full complement of leadership was a necessity.
Nanso so Petro ni asomafo na aka ne hunu se omunya panifo no ebo ano a eyepa bebo asafo no.
Because a church functions best when leadership is formidably in place and there is no void nor divided front.
Asafo bia no etimi koso wo mra mpaninie mpaninfo no ebo ano na tokro bia enam.
And this has an implication, serious implication for us.
Na yen so e wo ho susan so kese pa de maye.
This implies that for a congregation like ours,
eno chira se asafo ete se yen,
although we may also have some elders and deacons,
wo mu se wo asafo mpaninfo ni asomfo ni bi,
yet the moment we observe or it becomes obvious that there is a void in our leadership,
nanso emra yen be hunu se etokro bi eda yen empani nie nimu no no,
we should not hesitate to appoint those who qualify to fill that void.
Any ancestors adwentwen na asukra se ebe yi wo mu a omo se fata no ma be hye sa tokro ni mu.
The second observation we can make as we look at Acts chapter 1, the text we just read,
that
we observe that although there were a lot of brethren in the church,
a
lot of brethren, both men and women,
there
were a lot of them in the congregation at Jerusalem, yet the church did not fill the leadership void with just any member. They did not just grab any brother and said, oh, he's a brother. Yes, they were all Christians, but they would not grab just anyone and say, you, we want you to be an elder, or we want you to be this, or in this particular case, we want you to be an apostle.
They
put in place a system that was based on scripture, as a result of which they can get the best fit for the role.
Ah, na ejina Bible so oman namusu enya obi a osefata abedi adwuma no.
So we see that in filling the void that Judas created.
Enti okwan ya Judas jato ho no. Omunya omunkofa obi abesha anan no.
They were careful not to appoint someone like Judas.
But
instead, they were careful in finding someone whose heart is right with God. You see this in the way they prayed, verse
24.
Choosing someone whose heart is right in the sight of God. Think for a moment about Judas. Judas, for all intents and purposes, in all respects, Judas was there at the beginning of Jesus' ministry. Everybody saw him as an old member who has been around for long. Besides, Judas played a very prominent leadership role in terms of being in charge of the finance ministry. According to the Gospel of John chapter 12 verse 6. And so, outwardly, in the sight of the whole congregation, everyone saw Judas. That, oh, he is noble, he is qualified, he has been around for long, he plays this role. But inside him, in the sight of God, his life was filled with duplicity. Until he betrayed Jesus, everybody thought he was okay, he qualified. But then, as the event turned out, everybody saw what was inside him. His heart was not right with God. Therefore, in choosing someone to fill the void Judas created, the 11 apostles, together with the entire congregation in
Jerusalem,
resorted in taking four steps, what I call four sacred steps. Let me mention them quickly and then we take time to go through. The first step as a church they took was the study of God's word. And the second step we notice is that after studying the word of God, they did nomination. And then the third is they had intercessory prayer. And the fourth is they cast lot. I want to indulge. I want to crave your indulgence to give me some time and let's look at this four and we will learn a lot, I believe. Let me recap and repaint the picture again. Here is the Jerusalem church. There's leadership void that needs to be filled. There are a lot of brothers, even sisters in the church. The apostles could have used their own authority to grab anybody and say, you fill the vacuum. They didn't do that. By all means, the void needed to be filled. And so they adopted four steps. Step number one, Bible study.
Bible addition.
You find this from verse 15 to 20. When they realized the void, as I've said, in verse 15, Peter stood up and first of all, he brought the matter to the attention of the whole church. Then he turned the attention to the scriptures, studying the scriptures. They studied things that were relative to the qualification that was needed for appointing an apostle in
the case.
And the lesson here for us is that as a church, whenever we see the need for having additional leaders, whether they are elders or preachers or deacons,
we too
must resort to studying the Bible.
As I say, yes, so yes, Bible, no?
So that we will be well informed on the subject of qualifications, character, competence.
Na Bible no actually your father
of those we intend to appoint to leaders. So the question is, let me ask all of us. How well are you participating in the series of studies that we are having Sunday, Wednesday night and Sunday morning? You cannot say that you know it already, no. Some 65 and some 109, which was the text that Peter quoted. And was something that everybody in the Jerusalem church knew already.
Petro echo 2 years and I already can't some no. Jerusalem has a funan.
But when you respect God's word and when you are so determined to doing things according to the word of God, doing things to please God, you have to make yourself available to study the word of God anytime the need arises.
Na se wubu nyanku puansem. Na wo pese usue nyanku puansem no a. Ene na se biribia ra yebesua no oba na obesua bi.
So brothers and sisters, soon when the time comes for us to do the nomination.
Ente anuanom se emre eso na yebe yi enipanifo no a.
On what basis are you going to nominate anybody?
Wo ede na ogina so eyi obi.
It should be on the basis of how well informed we are about the word of God in relation to whether the person qualifies, whether the person has the wherewithal to perform the role that is required.
As I said, Gina Nimu, I will name free Nyangupon Sam, so Yangupon, you shall say, Winipano, or say, of Fata, we'll get to me a human.
So, number one, the Jerusalem church committed themselves to Bible study.
Yedi can't just ask for no, I shall Yangupon Sam.
Relative to the qualifications of the person who needed to be appointed. Step number two is nomination of potential candidates.
As 1:23,
my version says, so they nominated two men. When we have studied the Bible in relation to the qualifications and the role and the character and the competence of these men we want to appoint. Then we nominate people. The nomination, we should understand that it's not an automatic step where because they have been nominated, every one of them will necessarily have to be ordained.
Na say your friend Yanomwa, I don't say your friend Unkwa dear, say your sinipeni.
No, the nomination is a very important step.
Friend, I idea we are passing a best rebino.
It should be based on how well we understand their qualification and their competence in light of scripture.
Na your best friend cry, say, Gina, Nimwa, your nim, said your Bible, no can, or more who are day, any, almost say almost a fata.
But like the Jerusalem church,
I said, the Jerusalem master for a year, you
know. We need to just nominate and present them so that they will go through another step. And in this case, in our case, I want to remind us that when the time comes for us to nominate people, whether as elders or deacons, let's all remember 1 Timothy chapter 3 and Titus chapter 1. We always call it qualifications.
Yeah, Debbie, I say your qualification.
You are right.
I will call qualification, so. Yeah.
But in essence, actually, they are values.
Now, media, me who say a subain bi.
They are values, and when you sum it all up, all the qualifications, when you sum it all up, you have three different values that should inform us in nominating the people.
Now, qualifications na oho no. Wo kan nyina bomu a, wonya base subain subi base miensa.
So I said three, actually four.
Okay. Base nine. I say say obiara person depending yenya woni mu.
One of the values, one of the categories is that there should be evidence. There should be the evidence of character and disposition. And his character or disposition should not be questionable. That is what the Greek word without being blameless. The word being blameless means you cannot pinpoint any particular sin and say this person is guilty of this. It doesn't mean he is sinless.
Now, as someone I can't say so you're blameless, no? As I say, or you'll be a won't mean for bonny be and matana who now I don't just or you'll be a yabonny or yabonny, dear. Now, won't mean for matana who say what that's what you bonny way.
So, when you summarize a lot of the qualifications, you can reduce it to the person's character or disposition. And what you must ask yourself is, this man that I want to nominate, is his character or disposition questionable?
Number two, this person
that I want to nominate, you know, is there evidence of moral purity in his life? Or there is some element of his morality that can be questioned.
Now, what's the answer? I want to say, Onipa Miini, now Bra Bono Tiniana, and I said, Nisubaino, I said, Miss Abiwa.
Then, thirdly, is there evidence that he wields good influence in the church?
Now, what's the answer? I want to say, and you're also me and son, Asafumunu Susono, one can tense, Wapa, our Fufroswana.
How does he relate to people?
Because
his character may be good morally, you may not find anything wanting. But if the person exercises bad influence, then you have to put a question mark.
And the fourth value
is age and experience, not just chronological age, but age that comes with Christian maturity and experience. Sometimes I hear some of us bragging, oh, I got baptized in 1960, so what? The number of years you have been baptized means nothing unless there is evidence of Christ likeness in your life.
Do you know that in 1960, you were born as soon? Now, yeah, then 1960, you soon will buy and chira and cash.
The person probably may be relatively, if you like, relatively new in as far as the congregation is concerned. But in terms of age, in terms of his maturity and Christ likeness, if everybody agrees that he is a good fit, why not?
Eh, dear, now, sir, for no more, I'll buy one chair, Papa dear. Now, so if ye. And I say, Mumuni, and Christo Subaino, Wakwa Nimua, Aden, as it means, you know.
So, this should be the basis that should inform our nomination.
When in your mind, as ye, Gina, so ye will be.
So, the first step we are learning from the Jerusalem church is that they studied about the subject matter.
The deacon said, no more, no more, no more.
And on the basis of that, number two, they nominated. And then step number three, they embark on intensive intercessory prayer. Verse
24.
Listen to what verse 24 says. Then they all prayed.
Now,
oh Lord, you know every heart. Show us which of these two men you have chosen. Oh Lord, you know the heart of every man. You see, this is a prayer that acknowledges that as human beings, as a church, we can't know everything. We are limited. And so the Jerusalem church immersed the whole exercise in prayer, in selecting a replacement for the void that had been created.
And Jerusalem was afunun yina do mu rampai bomu ansa do mu tumi ayi obi abese Judas
anan. As human beings, we cannot be sure. We only see what the eye sees. And that is why if you nominate somebody and ultimately the person is not chosen, you should be careful. You should be careful in accusing or attacking the whole system.
Unless
you do not believe that the Spirit of God can control and direct the whole process as we pray.
I just said, what do you want to say? You want to say, you want to say, you want to say, you want
to say, for us in this congregation, the implication is that we have to come together with one mind and one purpose.
And
continue to pray and pray and pray. I've noticed that sometimes some of you are quick to attack, to criticize about things that are not going on well, but little do I even see you in prayer meetings.
But brothers
and sisters, this is not a mere human exercise. It's spiritual exercise.
And
this is the time for us to pray. And I don't know whether the elders have decided already, but after the nomination, I will want to see us as a congregation come together and declare a few days of fasting with prayers for this exercise. We have done it several times before in our history.
My name is Asafo Mpanimfo IWS. I am the person who said, "Ya bubu ni pani nyina di wi a, ye yi mri bi tu won ye ye mpae bo ni akonche, ya ye pen."
Here are apostles, 11 of them.
And
they mobilized the whole church to say that this is beyond what our human efforts can accomplish. So God, please come down. Show us. God, show us the ones you have chosen.
That must
be our prayer. Amen.
Amen.
That must be our prayer, my brothers and sisters. That must be our prayer. So, number one, they committed to studying the word of God. Number two, they nominated potential candidates. Number three, they immersed the whole exercise in prayer. And the fourth step, they cast lots. That is verse 26. So, are we ready to cast lots? Are we ready to cast lots? Because we want to do what the early church did. No, we can't do that. We can cast lots. The casting of lots was an Old Testament method of determining the mind of God. God's mind on any given matter. Read passages like Leviticus 16:8, Joshua 7:14, Proverbs 16:33, and several other passages. So, under the Old Testament, that was a system by which human beings discovered God's mind on a given matter. But for us today, who are New Testament Christians, the Bible doesn't permit us to cast lots. We do not cast lots. Today we do not cast lots to reveal God's mind. But rather we study God's word, and through the study of God's word and prayer and the exercise of discernment by spiritually mature Christians, we are able to determine the mind of God. That is what the New Testament teaches us. Therefore, in place of casting lots, in this congregation, we are going to create our own mechanism. And it's the mechanism that we usually refer to as selection committee. Such a committee is carefully put together by the elders. They should be a committee that should never think that they know it all and they are perfect.
And so say a committee, I'm going say, you be
perfect. But there should be a committee that is so Christ-minded.
And so say committee, you know, a nipa, umkita Christ adwen.
So that when they are put together,
say they be omoba say committee ya.
They will interact with those who have been nominated.
Omo aya bubu omudi no mno mbedi nkomo.
And then they will carefully carry out screening through careful discernment.
Now, what to a boa say? Aye, Mwasanimu,
and
Namu, and Yangupo, and
their mom. And they should go about their work with a high sense of objectivity.
Now, I do my normal yanson, and just one within the parish, and Nimu Bamukra.
They should neither fear nor favor anybody.
And that's what Muslo be, and then that's what Mubwa will be.
In addition, they should exercise their role in absolute confidentiality. Because you are interviewing, you are interacting with your own brothers, and certain things may come out that you need to keep your mouth
shut.
Apart from you, the committee member.
One committee member, no?
Or apart from the committee members themselves discussing the issues that come out.
I just say, "Bia, more committee members, no, na asemwe ba, you know, more share said yet."
None of the committee members should even discuss it with their wives or their children or anybody else.
Eti we a committee member, we ni wokwai so no we yere ana oba ana obi ayoko kan wa
asem. Until they have reached consensus.
I just say, "Yenyi na ye nya dwen ba."
And formally presented their views, their findings, or
now,
their report.
Committee, no, I do my addition. Once I say committee, no, or my bed, you know, better than this committee.
So the mechanism we put in place to ensure that there is discernment, there is confidentiality, there is brotherly love, and above all, they should ensure the best interests of the church.
And your coin, yeah, you need to or a year, and you move on. As I saw quite no more, be a narration, we saw, and the Kama Samoa, and my daddy, after so near your crown, and my baby, what as I for no a year.
The best interest of the church,
as I for no a year,
would mean that some people may not be appointed.
Now, as I for no a year, dear, they say, no, be a year, you know.
Although, on the face value, we all think that person may be qualified.
Maybe, yeah, let me pay this so dear,
the best interest of the church will require that some people should continue to serve.
As of new year, dear Tino, and says a binum, a BS, a binum to us, or some.
Although some of us probably may look at them with some kind of eyes.
Abia, they will be there, a dear Nibi, and a show.
That is the mechanism we put in place as if we are casting lots.
Or Quania, dear to what is said here,
and with prayer and the Holy Spirit directing and influencing the whole process, the final decision will be one that pleases God.
Exam time
is here.
And so here,
and it is not only the candidates whose life is being examined. Every one of you who nominate someone before God, your life, your conscience, your heart is being examined by God. The committee that is assigned this responsibility in the sight of God, your own level of maturity is being examined in the sight of God. Let us study the word of God. Let us then, on the basis of that, nominate those who we think have the potential.
And
let us saturate the whole process with prayer. And let us cast lot in our own style. By appointing the select committee to do the screening.
And committee.
Before I end my message, there is one important lesson that we can learn from the two people who were nominated by the church in Jerusalem. According to verse 24, actually verse 23, they nominated two men. One is called Joseph Barsabbas Justus, and the other is called Matthias.
Joseph Barsabbas and Justus, and Matthias.
By the way, if you are here and you are expecting a baby and you want a nice name for the baby, I want to recommend one for you.
Oh,
you pass it only a few days ago, so I won't suggest that name to you. But you know, the two men, one is called, his first name is Joseph. And then his Jewish name is called Barsabbas. Well, okay, it depends on where you place the emphasis.
Oh, Barsabbas.
But what it means is Kwame, Saturday born.
Na Barsabbas would you cast a mono yobi award memenda.
It's two word. Ba meaning son or one born.
The ban bano ye
and ba Sabbath from Sabbath, which is Saturday.
And a Sabbath, not to say Sabbath.
So one of them is called Joseph Kwame. And then his Roman name is Justus.
Na and your bakuye friend Joseph Kwame. Roman edis so the man here Justus.
I'm not playing here. There is a very important lesson for us to learn. Just by looking at the name, you try to appreciate some spiritual lesson value. The other one is called Matthias. And Matthias is a Jewish name meaning God's gift.
Matthias, a Jew for the and Chassi and Onyanko Ponachadi.
But when you look at the other one's name, Joseph Barsabbas Justus, the impression you get is that he was not from a Jewish stock. He was not a Jew. By his last name, he was not a Jew.
Joseph Barsabbas Justus.
So what's my point?
The
point is that it will be in the best interest of the church to have leaders who come from diverse cultural background, not just leaders who come from one particular background.
It is as someone best me can say. Ebe was afunopas ye was afunpenifua. E wamamre ne babi omu free omamaniano. E yes runko na nyese biya omu njina free amamre ba.
So even in nominating people, they were sensitive. They were mindful of the diversity. But then they cast the lot. And as you know, the lot fell on Matthias. His name means God's gift. So he's a gift of God. When you pray as a church, God will give you his gift, his
Amen.
Best.
Amen. Amen. Ni din no chire onyango pon achede ye bompa yesa safo a
After casting the lots, and the lot fell on Matthias. Not much is written in the Bible. Not much is known about these two men. But one thing we can be sure about is that throughout the nomination process and the casting of lots and the official appointment, there was no hint of accusation or grievance. The one who was not chosen, I believe, took it in good faith, and that shows maturity. Those in the church whose nominee was not chosen took it in good faith. Being humans as we all are, there is every likelihood that someone in the congregation felt disconcerted. For the fact that he was not chosen or his favorite was not chosen. However, there is no hint of accusation, no hint of dispute, no hint of bad mouthing.
Now, so Bible no more di anti so bi ko kasetia obi basabasa bi ebai.
I have a plea.
Me wa dis ready.
Brothers and sisters, in the sight of God, in the presence of God, this morning I am making a plea with you all.
Enu anom me gina nyangopon anima no pay me sra mu ade.
This exercise we are going to embark on in the next few weeks
will
be the sixth time in the history of this congregation, the sixth time we are appointing elders, biblically qualified elders and deacons. And the end result of what we are going to do in the next few weeks will say a lot about our level of Christian maturity. Let us all resolve. Let us all resolve to demonstrate the highest level of Christian maturity. Let us all resolve to do everything to bring about peace and harmony. Let every one single member of this congregation resolve to rise above pettiness and bitterness. Let those who go through the screening process show to God and to everyone that they are not title-loving
members.
Therefore, whether you are appointed as elder or not, the way you respond to the outcome will show whether you fail Christ or you pass the
exams.
Exam time is here. When the Jerusalem church realized that there was necessity to fill their leadership void, they studied on the matter. They nominated potential leaders. They prayed fervently. And they used human mechanism to determine who was the best fit for the role. May the Lord guide and bless us as we go through that process. And if you are here as a visitor, God has brought you here. Perhaps among the things you have learned this morning, you recognize the emphasis that we place on doing things according to the word of God. Yes, that is what we all need to do. The Bible says, he who rejects me and does not obey my word,
Bible said,
has one who will judge him in the last day. The worst that I have spoken, which is in the
Bible,
those shall judge you in the last day. So we give you heavenly opportunity this morning to resolve in your heart to repent, to turn away from your sin, and to surrender your life to Christ through immersion in baptism. And then the Spirit of God will do surgery, spiritual surgery on your life. You become born again, you become a child of God. God has great purposes for your life. He will bless you and nurture you, and someday God will give you a special responsibility. That will bring glory and honor to his kingdom. And so this morning we give you a heavenly invitation as we sing our invitation song. May God bless us.
Amen.